All right, welcome everybody. Sorry about last week, had about connectivity issues and Square Nine this week just didn't work out with my schedule, but we'll see what we can find today. Can you guys hear me all right? Awesome. Is anybody looking at a setup before we get into it? That we could analyze. I'll show you guys what I'm looking at here. So this is an interesting situation where we don't have, hey Adam, we don't have the stringent low created, right? We would like to see a low on both assets. So here, February 29th, 7 p.m. UTC, plus two. Let me just make sure I'm recording here. Yeah, okay. Euro made a low. Now, dollar Swiss made a low, but it made a low for only an hour. Like it rejected and then kind of started coming down. So the question is, do we classify that as a low or not? This is where we have to be a little bit dynamic. And I think the price action afterwards tells the story. So we can see that dollar Swiss has been heading down inverted, right? That's dollar Swiss original, so we're going to invert that. While euro dollar has been failing to break that low ever since, so this is just dragging down. And if we draw from that low, we're all the way down here. So there's clear divergence, maybe not in the cleanest way that we've been describing previously, but still something to take note of. But right now I just saw, okay, so we did break this low. So now we see the general divergence on the 1 hour. Let's go down to the 5 minute time frame. And both Euro and Dollar Swiss made a low. Where is that here? Not there. Oh, okay. So it's actually, yeah. So 12:30. Dollar Swiss made a low. And Euro dollar. Right, so what's the setup? Who wants to put it in the chat? You know, I know you guys know. Sam, what do you think? What's the setup here? Adam, Treyan, what do you guys think? Exactly, Adam. Euro USD long. All right, so this was valid, right around here, continued to drop, right? So let's just see how we can play this. All right, so if it was over here, we would have noticed there's a strong gap. But even if we wanted to enter up here, you can see there was no swing crossed, right? And we're big on swings being crossed, or at least candles, previous candles being crossed. So we made a large candles down, and now price is actually coming up. And I would say we can get past these wicks here. That would be a nice position long. So that's going to be for Euro dollar and dollar Swiss. Let's go to gold. Oh, nice. So I was looking long for gold. I missed that one. And silver. Oops, wrong side. Let's see what's going on here. So a lower time frame. We could see, you know, this is visible on the 1 hour. So price has been holding this area here. And while gold has run up, the question is silver going to catch up or is it going to be divergence down? Now, since gold is in a strong uptrend, right? We see here progressive bottoms. Keep taking out highs. So to short, this divergence would be very low probability. Unless, you know, silver can go up a bit and then break a swing. While gold retraces back into this level. Yeah, so gold and silver not looking too good today. No point going down on the smaller time frame. Very ambiguous here. Also, if possible, that we cross this swing, but that's going to be way too far already. All right, let's move on. What else we got? Let's go to Bitcoin. So Bitcoin has been on a tear. I wonder, did we have divergence here? Yeah, it looks like we did. So we broke below that right at the new block, exactly what I was saying in the previous sessions, that trend reversals, right, coming from a new block. So that's 2 a.m. 2 a.m. UTC plus 2, so UTC 0. And look at that divergence right at that time. Let's see what's going on at the moment. Obviously, we would not want to short this. And we'd be looking for divergences to the upside. So it looks like we had yesterday. Can go down to the 15 minute. Looking and trading. All right, over here it is. Oh, that's why. Beautiful. So that really came down strong. This is ideal divergence here, right? It's really pushing. No support whatsoever. While, you know, Bitcoin's being held really nicely there. And take note of the time. Once again, at the beginning of a new block. Right, so that's two main divergences, two moves here, just like we've been discussing, that the best time for Bitcoin and crypto in general is at the beginning of a new block, which is UTC zero. So you can see the statistical significance that it happened already twice in the past couple of days. And we have news coming up, I believe, at 10 a.m. Eastern, unless it already happened. Let's see here. No, 10 a.m. Eastern. We have PMI, manufacturing PMI. So that's going to be a big mover for all pairs. So I would just be marking out lows here. And waiting for a spike down into these lows, into these zones here, if for possible divergence. Because there's no way I'm going to be looking for shorts here. All right, let's look at the indices. So, you know, I teach in the course to use the S&P and the Dow, but I've been looking at the NASDAQ in the last year, getting to know it. And recently there was a setup between using all three as a group. So Gann also discusses in Truth of the Stock Tape when using divergences. So he talks about railways, right, and automobiles. So he's looking at a group or a class, right, of stocks together. But in the markets that we're looking at, we can't really, you know, use groups because it's not, things aren't that strongly correlated as they used to be. But in terms of indices, if we look at the S&P, the Dow, and the NASDAQ, it will give us an idea. So I'll just show you, I have a screenshot of a setup from this week. And it'll show you what I mean. Now, it was short-lived, but it was still valid nonetheless. Okay, so we can see that all three markets made a low, and then the S&P and Dow broke that low, but the NASDAQ didn't, and then it shot up right after. So that's a, you know, that's an element you can add by using these three indices as a group. And maybe give you some better clarity, because if two go one way and one goes the other way, it's going to be very, very high probability. So let's go back to the charts. Maybe we can look at three. So we'll do S&P, the NASDAQ, and the Dow. Awesome, Adam. Glad you like it, buddy. Let's go to the 1 hour first. Okay, let's get our bearings here in terms of this recent major top. Okay, so all indices, all three indices made a high at this time. But no divergence. You can see this one didn't go above, and this one didn't go above. So because it's only one that crossed, okay, this may lead me to apply logic that at least one of these are going to catch up and possibly everything will make a new high. And with the trend that we're in right now, just, you know, making new highs, we'd be looking for longs, just like, you know, we've been doing for the last few sessions. So I'll come to the lows here now. Okay, so there is an example of group divergence today, right? So where you might have missed out on a setup here. So this is right at the open of the day. I believe. Oh no, that was in London. So Tran says, if you want to experiment, you can also check the Russell 2000. Yeah, that's definitely a good idea. If you want to, like, this is what I've tested, so I can vouch for this. I haven't looked at the Russell 2000, but according to the logic, yeah, it would definitely be, then you would have a group of four, which is even stronger. So if you had three going, you know, breaking a zone, breaking a level, and one not, that one is going to be the leader in a bull market or a bear market. Okay, so here you'd be like, okay, well, I didn't see divergence, so I couldn't have caught this move up, right? Because they both broke the low here. But we had NASDAQ, oops, holding. And that would be, you know, very high probability for a move up. Two broke, one didn't, just like we've been saying right now, and up we went right away. Like it wasn't even, didn't even have to wait. We just had a huge spike. You know, take that. What is that? 1,000 points? 39. Oh no. We got here 200 points on what was that? On the Dow. Sorry, on the Dow, not the NASDAQ. So the Dow had divergence. So NASDAQ broke, S&P broke, Dow long. And we're still going from that divergence. Nothing's happened since then. Broke a high, broke a high. And then here we didn't, and it came down actually. But we don't want a short. Right? So we broke that high, broke that high. Here we held. And then down we went again, gave us an indication what would be a leader in the bearish move here. But now what I would be waiting for, same thing we did with crypto. I'd mark out these lows and I'd wait for a huge spike at the news or around the news or around the open. Into these levels and see if two can cross and one stays above. Clear? Any questions on that? Did we go through everything today? Euro, gold. Oil, haven't looked at in a while. Awesome, awesome. Let's see the Russell for shits and giggles. Where is four here? I want FXCM data. Yeah, so I would just observe this. So here, oh, we also had divergence on this one as well. So those lows, that low we were looking at before, which gave us the long on the Dow, looks like the Russell also crossed up. Interesting. Yes, we can look at the DAX and the France 40. The German DAX and the France 40, I believe we can do. We're going to add some new pairs now. How would I call that? Oh, it's called DE30, I think. Yes. And the France 40. So there we go. Had divergence there. Had divergence here as well. Oh, Sam, the Belgian, was that Belgian 20? I guess you could use that in a group, like for Europe too. Definitely, why not? All right, so I think we have a setup here, but we're way past these market times, I think. They're still open, right? These aren't aftermarket right now. When does London close? London closes in 2 hours, I believe. Sam, is the stock market open in Belgium right now? Yeah, this looks good here. I'd wait for a swing cross at least here. Just because the news coming up and New York Open coming up. But that is it. What were we looking at before? Dollar Swiss. Ooh, something happened here. Euro USD. Dollar Swiss. So dollar Swiss is breaking lower, much lower. And euro dollar is being held. We have clear divergence here. And now we're going to get 1 hour close. If euro dollar can stay here, we're going to get a 1 hour close here. That's going to be great. Okay. I thought so. I thought so. I thought the markets are open till then. This would be my favorite thing to watch going into New York for sure. Right here. Look at that. Look how dollar Swiss is just being let, right? Inverted again. Oops. It's being let off, so to speak. Like no one cares about it. It's just running, right? It's running its correlation, but it's taken off. Getting a bunch of buy orders, a bunch of longs, but we see the market maker over here, right? Because of their correlation. So euro should be down here with dollar Swiss, but it's not. So it's, and we're coming into the banks opening right now, right? All the banking system is coming online. So transfers are getting put through into accounts right now, at least in American bank accounts, Canadian bank accounts. Right, there's lots of activity about to happen. So this would be the time we'd want to look for something like this. But time shall tell. We shall see how the hour closes in a couple of minutes. And then we got the open and then news. Should be interesting Friday. Monthly, we're at a monthly open now. John Paul, welcome. We're actually just finishing up here, but I'll run through everything again quickly. So euro dollar divergence. We're looking for a long here. You can see we broke this low. Here we didn't. Let's run through everything one more time. Bitcoin, Ethereum. Definite uptrend, waiting for possible spikes down to one of these levels and to create divergence. In my opinion, least probable for today. Then we looked at the S&P 500. I discussed using a group with NASDAQ as well, but you can look at that in the recording. And same idea here. Where's the drawings? Same idea here. In the indices, we're looking for price to come down to one of these zones while breaking one pair, breaking the level, the other one not. So that's what we're looking at as well. What else did we go through? Oh, gold. So there is divergence down here, but I mentioned that we don't want to fight this huge uptrend here, these progressive bottoms. So with gold, you might want to wait till we converge back into the zone. And oh, here we go. So we talked about silver possibly rejecting, right? Making a minor low. And then the way we could trade this divergence from up here would be if silver actually comes down and breaks this and closes below. That would be a nice entry as well. But I got my eyes on euro dollar here today. And it's still going. Look at that. Complete opposite directions. All right, guys, that's going to be it for me today, unless anybody has any questions. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you have a great weekend. And we'll see you guys back here next week. Roger has a question. Shoot, Roger. Feel free to unmute your mic if it's too long to type. Oh, interesting. Yeah. So Bitcoin, a lot can be said. Maybe I'll put out a video on it. Let's take a look. So it's beyond the scope of these webinars. Let's take a look at the monthly. Because we went into this zone where this wick, monthly wick is, rejected and closed. Okay, so it's something I cover in the master program, but you know, just for the sake so you can understand maybe what we see here. But the reasoning is you know, a whole lesson. But basically, price should come back down here. But there's, you know, Bitcoin is a very abnormal market. But if I saw this form on any time frame, on any market that I trade, this would signal to me that price should head down, at least back down to this area. Will it happen on Bitcoin? No idea. Right now, all signs pointing up. But if we have another month that, you know, the volume starts to die here, we get smaller candles and then cross lower, that's going to be bad news. Or, you know, what we could get is price coming all the way back down, like make another red candle halfway through here. Hey, Ray, sorry, we started at 3:30 today. had to start a little earlier today. Is in the email. Yeah, sorry guys, double check the times. I try to be consistent, but schedule whatever my schedule allows. Have the recording up soon, Ray, so you can take a look. Yeah, no worries. But in terms of divergence on the monthly for Ethereum, is that because of triple top? No, Adam, that's because of and I'll give everybody a hint, that's because of the U-boat scare. You remember what cotton, and I'm giving you guys, so whoever's watching these webinars, right, you guys are getting gold, I'm telling you. Gann'S, yeah, awesome. Gann'S discusses, there's actually a question. Again, this isn't a published work. It's for free for everybody to read. The question is understanding it properly and applying it to a modern market. And that's what I try and guide people with. So the question there is, I'll end on this. The question there asks, to Gann is, can we know about events that are unexpected? And Gann goes to a, through a few examples there, like the beginning of a war breaking out, or the death of a president, or other world events or catastrophes like floods. So how would that affect cotton and wheat? So he goes through an example there, and he basically shows how we could understand based on the form that the market is making, based on the picture. Gann talks about the market making a picture there. So the picture that the market is making will let us know about the next step. And based on what Gann teaches, there's a very clear picture here that, we've made a secondary slightly lower top, that price should come down. All right. But in terms of divergence, we've diverged here, I believe. And this was a very important high. This is where, unexpected lows were made. There was a panic here. So the divergence is also supporting this idea. Right? We've closed above on the monthly basis, which is very strong, while Ethereum has closed below. So for those two reasons, I wouldn't be so thrilled, like so elated like everybody is. It's pretty cool that Bitcoin got all the way back here. It just goes to show the astro that's within it is very strong. Of basically revolution of money is tied into its astrology, and you can see there's free videos on YouTube on that everywhere. But yeah, that's pretty much what I see at a higher time frame. But we have to watch this level here. It can't break above 3600. If we get above that level, then this divergence is invalid, and we could end up running up here, and Bitcoin can end up making new highs very easily, go to 100K, no problem. That's just based on, price action here and how this chart looks. If I was just to judge it as a chart, no problem. And if you guys remember when I was doing my live streams, I was calling these prices, from here. We were taking it step by step, but I basically broke down there. You guys can go check it out on the YouTube channel, step by step, what would need to happen if Bitcoin would run up here, and it was definitely a possibility. Let's see what euro and did we get hourly divergence? Yes, we did. I don't know why it didn't show, but it, oh, I think I don't. So again, this is the level right here. But we got news soon, so we'll see in an hour. So that's going to be it, guys. Have a great weekend. Hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to reach out if you have any questions, and I'll speak to you next week. My pleasure, guys. Take care.